Welcome back guys to another video today, and this is the second part of the game week predictions that we are going to continue till the end of the Premier League season. So as you know, we started this last week, so this is game week 2 prediction, and this will continue till the 38th game week that we are going to have. So you know, we had an exciting last week, some great results, some great goals, some great comebacks. And we all know that it's even going to get better this week because teams are even going to be more fit and are going to be more into their Premier League season. So let's get into it and let's start with the first match this week, which is Everton versus West Brom, which takes place this Saturday, 19th of September at 5 p.m. Indian Standard Time. So Everton and West Brom is a very, very intriguing clash. Everton went away to Tottenham Hotspur and they won 1-0. Now even I didn't anticipate that coming. I expected Jose Mourinho's team to be defensively solid and keep a clean sheet and beat Everton. But to even my surprise and the whole Premier League, Everton went there, they did not just beat Tottenham, they decimated them. They decimated Tottenham. If Richarlison had his finishing boots, that could have been 2-0, 3-0, 4-0, whatever Everton wanted. So Everton really performed well. On the other hand, West Brom, they tried to take the game to Leicester and they played some good stuff at it sometimes. But they were thrashed by Leicester and they were shown the reality of the Premier League. Now even you guys who would have seen my Everton vs West Brom preview, because I also put the link in the description, I've also made an article differently where I explain about West Brom. West Brom attackingly have a lot of problems and I can't see many of their players scoring a lot of goals this season. And West Brom have very, very lack of goals in them this season. So I think in these problems that West Brom have and not having a goal scorer and Everton being so strong, I think Everton will prevail as winners in this match. Now again, this won't be like the Tottenham match. Here, Everton are the front runners. Everton will be expected to attack while West Brom will sit on the back and wait for the opportunity like what Everton did against Tottenham. But I just think the Everton's attack and West Brom's ruthless attack, this is just going to be an Everton clean sheet where I think Carlo Ancelotti's side will prevail as 2-0 winners. The second match of this week we go on is between Leeds versus Fulham. Two promoted sides that come up against each other on the second day of the season. So both the teams have same points tally, that is 0 points. But both started it very differently. Leeds, they went to the champions and they were just some minutes away. They were 3 minutes of normal time away from salvaging a draw from the champions. They went at the champions' home ground and they put 3 past the champions. And it took Liverpool a 4-3 penalty to win the match. That's how well Leeds played. On the other hand, Fulham played also a top side in the league, in Arsenal, and they were decimated. Arsenal destroyed them. The way the defending and the keeping that Fulham showed that day. I'm really sorry Fulham fans, but it looks very difficult for a team to survive this season. So I just cannot see Fulham surviving this season. But that's a different story. I think in this match we will see players like Areola coming up instead of the goalkeeper, but I can't see any other difference. And Fulham defense is very, very bad. Now, as I've again and again told you, whenever these two sides play each other, there's a lot of draws in between them. And Leeds will not find it easy. Liverpool was a different team. Leeds were expected to counter. This is the match where Leeds will have to be the front runner. And Fulham will try to strike on the counter. But except Mitrovic, again, I can't see Cavalero or Cavanova making a big, big difference. And therefore, I think that Leeds will just have enough to pull a victory in themselves. I think it's going to be Leeds 2, Fulham 1. The third match that is going to take place this week is between Manchester United versus Crystal Palace. Now, unfortunately, Manchester United City had no matches last week because of the COVID situation. And it was not to do with COVID situation, to be honest. It was more to do with that due to COVID situation when the league started a bit late. So the Europa League, Champions League campaign also gets stretched. And these two teams mostly had to play their matches till August 15th, 20th. So I think they were given a bit of leeway by the Premier League to start their campaign a bit late. So their first some matches got postponed And this is the first match for Manchester United this campaign. Now, the last time these two sides played at Old Trafford, Palace prevailed as 1-2 winners. You all remember the Daniel James celebration where many Man U fans blasted him for the celebration at 1-1. And what happened was unfortunate for United fans, where Patrick Hanold scored at 93rd minute by a David De Gea mistake, and Crystal Palace won. But if United fans have to see a full reading, then it gives a good reading for them. They accept that win. Palace have not beaten United. Palace have just 2 draws and 1 win from their last 14 matches against United in the Premier League. They have lost whooping 11 matches out of 14 competitive matches in the Premier League. They have played Man United. But one worry United and the Ole Gunnar Solskjaer are going to have is the last 2 matches that these 2 teams have played at Old Trafford that have ended Man United 0, Crystal Palace 0. Man United 1, Crystal Palace 2. So I think that will be a bit of worry. But in this match, Crystal Palace again have a very much injured backline. United have players like Bruno, Martial, Rashford, Pogba, Greenwood. So I think again, I will give this team to all things. United players will not be immediately fit. It will be a bit more time. But with an injured backline that Crystal Palace have and already having players that have told you, along with a new signing, Donny van de Beek, it looks difficult for Palace to get anything. United defence is a bit more leaky. So I see Crystal Palace getting one goal through Zaha or Eze. But overall, I think it will be a comfortable 3-1 victory for United. With I think Bruno, Martial, Rashford all being on the score sheet, while Zaha getting a goal for Crystal Palace. So I think it's going to end Manchester United 3, Crystal Palace 1. So the next match we move on is between Arsenal versus West Ham. So I think this should be a very exciting match between two London teams. Two teams who are good rivals. But I think unfortunately the campaign they are having is one team is coming with full of optimism, positivity. They are looking forward to this match. While other is coming in a very bad form. West Ham were destroyed by Newcastle in their first match. It's your home match. But the negativity in the West Ham camp is at utmost high. It's at utmost high. So West Ham have negativity creeping all over their campaign. While Arsenal, they beat Fulham 3-0. They won the Community Shield final against Liverpool. The signings, Gabriel had a good game. Willian had 3 assists. So it's all going well. Now whenever these sides have played, the last win West Ham had at Emirates Stadium was in 2015, which was the opening match of the season. Who can forget the meltdown at AFTV? But overall, that was the last time that West Ham beat Arsenal at Emirates. Overall, Arsenal left facing them at Emirates. And I can't see anything being different this time. I think Arsenal are going to win this match 2-1. I think this is a match against a bigger team, so West Ham players will be up for it. And especially heavy players like Declan Rice, who are going to be good in the midfield. Players like Noble, who will be up for this game. Bowen, even Haller if he's played. So West Ham have some good players on their own day if they can play to their abilities. And Antonio. So I think they will get a goal and they will put a hard fight. But I think Arsenal will have just too much enough optimism and positivity to prevail them out of it. So I think it's going to be Arsenal 2, West Ham 1. So the next match we move on is a Sunday match, which is going to take place at 4:30 Indian Standard Time, which is very early to be honest. So I think this is between Southampton and Tottenham. Now this is a very exciting match because both teams had high anticipation this season, but both are coming into it in a very horrid form. Southampton has just been knocked out of Carabao Cup by Brentford, a championship side. Now Brentford are a very established championship side, but it's embarrassing for Southampton to lose to them. Tottenham on the other hand, it took Tottenham 3 red cards of the opponent team to beat Lokomotiv Plovdiv 1-2 in the Europa League. That is embarrassing. That is literally embarrassing. And they lost to Everton at home 1-0. They have literally on the verge of signing Gareth Bale. And it looks like he might be out for 4 weeks. Great days. So they're struggling. On the other hand, their football is also very horrid to watch. And it's not even working. On the other hand, Southampton. Now this was a team we had high anticipation of this season. Because Hasan Hüttl has got them playing a very good system. And I still think Southampton will do well this season. But the first match, the way they started, they were easily beaten off by Crystal Palace. Then the Brentford match. So it's not a good start for them this season. Now, if we see their record at Saint Mary's Stadium, then Tottenham have not won their last three games in the stadium. Their last three games have been Southampton 1, Tottenham 1, Southampton 2, Tottenham 1, Southampton 1, Tottenham 1. But one thing I think people who play games like FPL, who play games like these FPL 11 teams that they make, then Harry Kane is a very predominant figure in this picture. Harry Kane has 7 goals in his last 6 matches against Tottenham Hotspur. So if you want to pick Harry Kane, you should go for him as a captain because this is his favourite team. He is 100% going to score here. But I think this match is going to end 1-1 because Tottenham are so bad. Southampton not coming in good form. But this is a stadium Tottenham struggling. And Southampton will play better at home because I think this is the second match and they have to play better with all the problems. And Southampton still have a very good system. So I think Hasan Hüttl will do a good job and he will get his team a 1-1 draw against Tottenham. This was the first Sunday night match. The second Sunday night match is between Newcastle versus Brighton. In Indian time, this is a 6:30, which is a type of evening or night time. But in UK time, it will be a bit of evening. So I think you have to see how this match goes. So Newcastle and Brighton. Now this is going to be a snooze fest, a sleeping time, if we go by the recent history. These teams, the last three times they have played each other at the St. James Park, it's been Newcastle versus Brighton 0-0, Newcastle versus Brighton 0-1, and Newcastle versus Brighton 0-0. So it's really going to be snooze fest if we see the history. But I think this time, if you see Brighton against Chelsea, Brighton were very unlucky to lose against Chelsea. Brighton played superbly well, but Reece James Turner denied them, and Chelsea had just better quality on the day. Newcastle also have done a very good job in this transfer window. And there's a lot of optimism going at that place. But I think this match will have goals in it. I think it's going to end Newcastle 2, Brighton 1. Newcastle are just going to get the job done. They'll get goals from Callum Wilson. They have more goal scoring option. And I think Callum Wilson will be on the score sheet. Well, Brighton will have, I think at Brighton, Mopey will score a goal. And I think it's going to end Newcastle 2, Brighton 1. Now we move on to the biggest fixture this week. And that is between Chelsea versus Liverpool. Since Jurgen Klopp has made the statement of we are a different club and then straight away going on and buying Thiago and these all players, I think the rivalry has increased, especially with the post-match fights between Klopp and Lampard. Now we all know that's just simple part and it happens, but this match is a very exciting match in other terms because this is the match which will show what Chelsea are made of. This match will show us whether the gap has been bridged between Chelsea, Liverpool and City, or Chelsea still are way far behind. Because I still don't think Chelsea are going to win the Premier League, but can Chelsea close that 30-point gap? With players like, even Pulisic is unavailable, Chilwell is unavailable, Ziyech is unavailable, Chelsea still have players like Havertz, players like Werner, players like Mount, players like Hudson-Odoi, players like Giroud. They will have Kovacic back for this game, Kante, Jorginho. Chelsea have enough in the bank to give this Liverpool team a big go. Now Stamford Bridge has been a very good hunting ground for Liverpool. They won here last time 1-2. They drew 1-1 under Maurizio Sarri, where you know Daniel Sturridge scored one of the best goals we'll see. Then Chelsea won under Antonio Conte 1-0 by Giroud header. Before that, again Liverpool won 1-2 under Antonio Conte when Chelsea won the Premier League. And even before that, their defeat was like the biggest killer in sacking of Mourinho when they came to Stamford Bridge and they won 1-3. Which was like Klopp's one of the biggest victories before he beat City 4-1. But I think this has been a very good hunting ground for Liverpool. But I don't think so it's going to continue. Chelsea are going to surprise them in my regards. I think it's going to be Chelsea 2, Liverpool 1, with Timo Werner scoring a brace while Salah scores for Liverpool. And Chelsea are going to stun a lot of people. So it's going to be Chelsea 2, Liverpool 1. Now we move on to another game that's going to take place, and that is Leicester versus Burnley. And this is also a late Sunday match because we will have two matches on Monday. So this is between Leicester versus Burnley. So Leicester and Burnley, like, it's been a very intriguing record between these two teams. As you know, Burnley beat Leicester 2-1 at their home stadium but lost to them at King Power Stadium. The last four matches these teams have played at King Power Stadium, Leicester have won 3 while only drawing 1. So I think Leicester have a very good hand over Burnley at home. And especially the way Leicester played in the first game, 3-0 victory, Leicester have a lot of optimism to build them around. Burnley, on the other hand, they did not have the first game week because they had to play United, but United were not available for the first match. So I think it was postponed. But Burnley still played a good performance against Sheffield United in the Carabao Cup and went through on penalties. So they will have some match fitness. So I think we come to this match, we all know. See, every Premier League fans know what Burnley is going to do. They're going to sit tight and they're going to wait to pounce upon you. So I think it's literally going to be Burnley sitting back and Leicester attacking, which won't be easy. But in my regards, Leicester have just too much quality to break them down. I think it's going to be Jamie Vardy scoring a goal and it's going to be Leicester 1, Burnley 0. Now we move on to Monday fixtures, and one is between Aston Villa vs Sheffield. Now Aston Villa vs Sheffield made us saw a big controversy. It was regarded as a controversy which relegated Bournemouth, because Sheffield had scored a goal but it was ruled out and the match ended in a 0-0 draw. This was the first game. This was the first proper game we had since the lockdown got opened and everything started getting back normal and football was back. This is going to be a very, very exciting fixture. Last year they had a 0-0 draw and before that Sheffield beat them 2-0. But in the championship, Villa did come back 3-0 down and they came back 3-3 against Sheffield United after 80th minute. So this has always been a fixture of goals until and unless they've played each other in the Premier League. So I think this is going to be a very, very good fixture. Sheffield have not started the campaign well. Sheffield have went there and Sheffield have lost the first game at home to Wolves. They've also been knocked out of the Carabao Cup. It's not going a good time for them. While Aston Villa, they have signed some good players. Matty Cash extended a contract of Grealish. They've got a great goalkeeper in Martinez. So I think Aston Villa are really going to... Aston Villa are already trying to get themselves secure this season. But I think Aston Villa will just not have enough on them to beat Sheffield. But I think they'll get a draw against them. So it's going to be Aston Villa 1, Sheffield 1. And then we move on to our final game, that is between Wolves and Manchester City. This is a very exciting game. We all can remember the tune of the commentator, Traore! So Traore really stunned the whole Manchester. Traore had a big hand in finishing Man City hope of winning the title. The losses to Norwich and Wolves shattered City's hope in fight against Liverpool. Last year, Wolves did a double over City. They came back from 2-0 down to win 3-2 at the Molineux and they won at City's ground 2-0. Now they have signed players like Fabio Silva and Marcel this window, while City have signed players like Nathan Ake and Ferran Torres. So has City massively improved? No. Has Wolves massively improved presently? No. Wolves have also started their campaign very strangely. They have lost in the Carabao Cup game, but they also won their match last week against Sheffield United, where they scored 2 goals within 6 minutes. So now how is this game going to end? I think this is going to be a tight game where Wolves will try to remain tight and try to counter with players like Jimenez, Traore. I think Jota is on the verge of going to Liverpool, but he might just feature in this game. While City will also rely on their attack. But I think City defense is always leaky, so they will give a goal away. But I think City will still find 2 goals to score. So I think it's going to be Wolves 1, City 2. And I think that brings our Premier League game week 2 predictions to an end. I hope you like it. Please like and share, guys, and please support. Thank you so much.